Gemini is about to change Gmail as we know it. And I recently sat down with Blake Barnes, he's VP of Product at Gmail, to discuss what Gemini in Gmail is really going to mean for the future of Gmail. How is this different from the AI features we've seen before? What can users, you and I, expect? And yes, of course, keep your eyes peeled on this channel because I will have a full walkthrough for you and tutorial, you know I will, of exactly what these features will look like inside Gmail. Blake and I cover a lot in this conversation, and he really unpacks this fundamental shift in Gmail and what it means for you. So without further ado, enjoy the conversation. When we're talking kind of about, you know, like this broad category of AI in Gmail, if you will, and all that that entails, can you talk a little bit about the shift from, you know, what these consumer features looked like at the start? So say, whether we're talking about like a smart compose or smart reply, to where Gmail's going now towards the future of AI in Gmail and what it really means for users.
We understand that, you know, we have over 3 billion people using Gmail today, and there's a certain sense of reverence for the product. I mean, people really connect with it. It's very personal for them. And we want to respect that. And so as we think about evolving Gmail, we think about how do we do that in a way that brings the best technology that Google has to bear to the workflows and the products that people already know and love in ways that feels natural to them and ways that feels like an extension of the product they've already gotten used to. That's a key tenet for how we think about these products. And I think, you know, you can see that in a number of these features. For example, the AI overviews in emails that we talked about. It's a nice subtle box at the top of your threaded email lists. You know, this email list looks the same, but now you've got an option at the top there to see a summary. And if you don't like it, you can just collapse it and it just goes away. The suggested replies, they're integrated in one click. And as we think about how to do that across the board for our paid features like Proofread, again, they're extensions of the spelling and grammar, the flows of the underlines all stay the same. With search, you type a query, you can still do keywords queries like you always could, but now you can do natural language queries too. And when you get a response, you certainly get the emails listed below, but now you also get a synthesis at the top, a summary of giving you your specific answer. And it's naturally integrated into the experience that you already know and love without you losing anything. And so that's how we think about this. That's how we think about evolving our product. It's bringing it in a way that's integrated naturally. Now, the last thing I'll say on this is the other feature that we're really excited about, which is AI inbox. It's a whole transformatively different way of working at looking at email. And we're starting that with trusted testers and expanding from there, but it's gonna be an entirely different experience, right? Which is why the existing inbox isn't getting touched. We're keeping that there and you can always get back to it. But when you wanna try something new and novel that can really help you better understand what's important in your life, you can click the AI inbox button. And when you get there, you'll see an entirely different way of looking at things. You no longer see a reverse chrono list of your emails. In fact, you don't see any specific email at all. You see a full synthesis of your entire inbox of what's important to you right now. The priorities at the top, the catch me up at the bottom. Now, this is novel. This is different. This will feel different to people. And that's intentional because we wanted to give ourselves the space to evolve and innovate and, you know, change what this product is at its core, while still staying true to our principles that we talked about of helping people to feel comfortable. You know, the AI inbox is supposed to make people feel like Gmail has their back. And it can only do that if they feel like they still have access to all the good stuff that they've always had and that they're using it out of, you know, desire and an eagerness to see what this new technology can provide for them. And so that's generally how we think about this type of situation.
And I wanna, you know, I'll circle back in a minute on this AI inbox because I do think it's kind of crazy and mind-blowing. But as a recap for people quickly on the newest features, we've got Proofread, we've got AI overviews in search, and then this AI inbox. So, you know, like to step back for 1 second and talk about Proofread briefly, like I think something Google in general, but Gmail's always done really, really well is allowing people to stay within the ecosystem. So like, instead of having to switch back and forth between products or apps and like allowing us to be more most productive in where we are living and working. So in talking with about Proofread, like I'm viewing this as kind of a complete replacement for third party plugins, if you will. So in a nutshell, can you just give us a quick overview of what is the Proofread feature in Gmail and why, even though it seems small for some people, it might be a big game changer?
Yeah. So, you know, we think about features through the lens of customer value, of user value, what's useful for them. That's our North Star. That's what we're always going back to. And when you think about what's most useful for a lot of people, it's getting value in the flow of work, in the products that they know and love, without having to deal with any other setup or other sorts of things like that. So that's our North Star. It's sort of, to your point, making it simple, easy, and straightforward. That's the principle. Now, that principle applied to Proofread, I think, is really interesting because we've had spell check and grammar check for a while, but this new Proofread is different, right? It offers really sophisticated analysis to give you things like improved clarity and structure. So it's going to give you one-click suggestions for a whole range of things, things like word choice, conciseness, active voice, and even splitting out complex sentences. So if you type a run-on sentence and the model determines that it might be more effective to say that it's two sentences, we're going to give you that one-click press to split it out. And so unlike spelling and grammar checks, which were just like word by word or neighboring words, this is looking at the full email. It's looking at the full sentence, the full paragraph, and it's looking at a whole range of things. It's not just about spell check and grammar. It's about, you know, how to communicate your idea in a more concise, clear way. And the product understands what you're trying to communicate and helps you do that in a way, to our previous point, more intuitive and like an extension of what you are already used to with Gmail. And that's why we're so excited about it.
And so it's pulling contextually from the history of my inbox, for lack of a better term, to know, like, not only helping me grammatically, but how I would speak, maybe.
Yeah, it's helping you, to get that more concise, clear email to help you get the point across. And it's pulling within the context of that email to help you do that. And I think that's one of the things that makes it really cool, right? It's personalized to you in that way.
Let's move on very quickly to this search functionality, because I think these AI overviews, not to be dramatic, might change the way we search in Gmail forever. I've always been a big believer that Gmail has nailed search all the time. Like, there's a lot of other email providers, if you will, that it's like I never sent the email. You can't find anything. And so I feel like this could be a real game changer. So walk us through first, you know, what this AI overview feature is going to actually look like in search, and then how it's maybe changing, like, our inbox search experience from what we're used to.
I am really excited about this feature. Like, it's going to, I think, transform the way people use search in Gmail, right? So there's a few things that are going to be different. One is that, you know, the search box now will also accept natural language queries. You can type in a question, right? Like, what size Brooks sneakers do I wear? You can do that in addition to the keyword searches you've already been able to do. So you can type in just a way that you are thinking, right? And the search will handle it for you. The second thing that will be different is that you see at the top a synthesis that gives you your specific answer. So it looks through all of the results in your inbox, and it gives you a specific answer summarized right at the top. And I think people will see this metaphor and understand this experience from Google search, right? I mean, Google search has the set of blue links, and at the top now we have this AI overviews that give you an answer right at the top of everything across the web. This experience will feel very similar. You type a query in, now we can do natural language. You still see the emails, they're still there. And if you want to go right to those, you can. But at the top, you'll also have an AI overview that works just over your inbox and your personal inbox to give you the specific answer you're looking for. You'll tap a button, you can expand it, go deep. There's also ways for you to click into different parts of the summary to go to the emails that are referenced and cited that in that they're part forming that specific answer. So you can gain increased confidence that the answer we're giving you is the right one.
Yeah, this is incredible because I've loved AI overviews in search. So this just makes sense now. It's a natural extension, as you're saying. So it's essentially pulling from our entire inboxes. So to me, it's like if you were an early adopter from 04 or something, that's a lot of information. So how does the Gmail team actually ensure that it's pulling the most accurate, helpful, and relevant information for users?
There is an incredible range of like technology that goes into making this work. And I think that there are a couple key parts to it. The first is around relevancy, right? We build an incredible number of systems to kind of handle relevancy just for one person to figure out what is the relationship between all these different emails. And how do we make sure to understand their relationships for the full experience that you've used on Gmail? Because from a user's perspective, you don't care where the email came. You want to have that, to your earlier point, you want to be able to get the answer to your question no matter when it is or who sent it. And so we have to index all of those and make them all accessible. So that's the first part, it's just around relevancy. But the other part is around scale, right? Because we want to be able to give these features to a large number of people. And we're starting with AI overviews and search with our pro and ultra users, which is a lot of folks. And to get that right, that relevancy right at scale for the wide range of use cases that people want and the wide range of situations that they experience is another huge technical challenge that we've gone and conquered here to bring this product to market. But the truth is, you know, from our perspective, this is just the start, because we're going to put this product in market and people are going to tell us what they love about it. They're going to tell us how we can make it even better. They're going to find new ways to use it and new answers that we can help them, you know, redress in Gmail. And we're just going to be excited to be on that journey and rapidly bring even better improvements to market every single day.
Now, something you brought up earlier is this AI inbox that's going to be available for trusted testers. So what can users expect from this in terms of how it's, I think, fundamentally could change their Gmail inbox experience as we know it?
I think you're right. I think fundamental shift is the right way to think about this. This is the first time that anyone will have experienced email like this ever. And that's one of the things I want to make sure that people understand and see and get. Because we get it too. And that's one of the reasons why it's going to be a separate experience that people can keep using their traditional inbox. But when they get this AI inbox, and starting with trusted testers tomorrow, when they get this personal inbox, this AI inbox, it'll feel different. And what they'll see is a couple things. They'll see that it's a set of synthesis. It's looking across your entire inbox. There's not individual emails listed, but instead a summary of the particular action items that you need to take right now. Looking across your entire set of inbox and pulling them down into a broad set that says, hey, do this, this, and this, with references to those emails. And I think to your point, it does kind of change how people think about this experience, because it's not hunting and pecking for individual email, but it's sort of saying, wow, email, you know, AI is helping me look across my entire inbox and surfacing what's most important. And the stories we've heard so far is this product catching people, right? Meaning like preventing things from falling from the cracks. We've heard situations where people caught details around missed bills. We've heard situations where they, for example, learned that they were supposed to bring a book instead of a card to their baby shower, and they would have showed up to the baby shower with the wrong thing and saved them from that embarrassment. And so really it's something that gets your back that we want you to rely on to say, hey, what else is going on right now? And that's where AI Inbox is going to be really powerful and really novel and an amazing experience for so many people.
And this is opt-in, correct? So if people want their lovely old way to use Gmail, they could still do that, right?
100%. And so this goes back to some of the earlier principles we talked about. We're bringing these features in a way that centers the user and centers what people are trying to accomplish. And we're doing that in a way that integrates it naturally to existing workflows. And for moments like AI Inbox, which are really novel and which are really innovative, we're doing it in a way that's opt-in and without disrupting traditional inbox flows. So people will still have their regular inbox. You know, they'll still be able to look at emails and process emails in the same way. If they're set up any rules with labels or otherwise, those will all still work. This is just going to be another tool for them to use to really make sure they've got everything covered and to breathe a big sigh of relief that, yes, everything's under control.
Yeah, inbox overload is a real actual issue. So I know people are going to be concerned a lot. You know, like if you're like me, which I'm sure there's got to be more people like me where my whole life is pretty much between Gmail and Google Calendar. Like Google knows more about me than I probably know about myself at this point. So, you know, when you're approaching things like training and privacy and security, how do you approach all that with these features?
Yeah, I think, you know, when we think about this, we think about, you know, the trust that people are placing with us, right? And we understand that. you know, to bring AI into these tools, people need to place a large amount of trust in us. And so we have a whole range of tools that we use to do this in the right way. It's a whole secure privacy architecture to make this work well. So, you know, in that, one thing I want to make really clear is that we distinguish between the AI that helps you and the models we build for everyone. So when you use Workspace Gemini features, including the ones we've talked about today in Gmail, we do not use your personal content to train our foundational models. That's a really important distinction for us to make. And we think about that very carefully, and we do a whole bunch of things like, for example, process your information in secure store environment that's just for you. And then that's the foundational bedrock of really all this great value that we've been talking about.
Thank you so much for your time, Blake. I appreciate it.
Thank you. I hope you have a great rest of your day.
All right. You know I want to hear from you. What do you think of these new Gemini features inside of Gmail? Do you love them? Do you hate them? Are you indifferent? Leave a comment below and let's have a discussion about it. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gmail and Gemini and all the Google goodness. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.